The pinnacle of MPC kits is back. 2021 round two models reissuing the 1/16th scale Petty 73 Dodge Charger. This is a massive kit. It is full of outstanding decals, or details and decals. They show you everything on the box. You can use the box for your super detailing, for checking out all the extra awesome stuff on the kit. Let's get right to all the stuff in the box. Now at the end of the video, there, look at that, there will be pictures of each individual parts sprue as well, so you can see exactly what's going to be coming in the kit. Look at the size of that body, almost 13 inches long when we're all done with it. It is huge, gigantic, beautifully molded, even though it's been produced a gajillion times. Sold so many of these. The flash, I mean, it's not, there's nothing wrong with the molds. They're beautiful. They're in great shape. Look at this slab. That's so much plastic in there. I'm surprised they didn't have to join OPEC to produce it with that much oil. Look at the size of that thing. Excellent detail. This is a super detailer's dream. There's a good amount of aftermarket support. Look at that. That's not a sled. That's the hood. You can put the kids in this and go right down the hill on it. That thing's got more square footage than my first apartment. Beautiful kit. Done up well, all ready for you to build and have fun. I will link down in the description when we're done with this video where you can snag your own. I mean, just look at all the detail MPC put into these. The pinnacle, like I said, just outstanding. Padded roll cage, wrapped roll cage with the padding over it. Just lovely. So you, like I said, you super detailers out there can really go to town on this, but the kit itself comes out massively detailed right from the box. They're even going to have the lines I'll show you in the manual for the oil coolers, the pumps. We got our battery there. They've got all the stuff in there. So we've got cutouts on the dashboard for a cool part I'll show you. Got the charger logo in there. Got the racer seat with the belts molded in so you can detail them. I mean, we are talking exquisite detail. Got the right style of padding on that giant roll cage. You know, if you needed a roll cage in your real car, you just take this out, put it in there, it'd be fine. It's giant scale. We've got a nice set of 16 scale jack stands with handles. You can set it up without its wheels on to look underneath and check out the brakes and the lines and the hoses. You could use this on your regular models to lift them up, even the smaller scale. They'll still look cool underneath it. Check out the size of the headers. Awesome sauce. More roll cage parts. More front suspension and chassis. Just amazing, down to the collectors and everything. We got cylinder heads. Headers, look at the valve train. Rockers, water pumps, look at the carburation on there. Check out the block halves, you can see the pistons in their proper positions. And it's even a proper carving for a hemispherical head piston. Just lovely molding, you gotta get this kit. Transmission separate, look at that intake. Distributor with holes in it, what does that mean? Alternator. All the little fins, air cleaner, even the bottoms have nice detail. You can put it together. We got suspension components, drivetrain, suspension arms. I mean, look at the just sway links, steering links, spindles. Outstanding. We've got some random body parts here like firewall. Even that's got carved in detail. Trim, underbody spoiler parts. We've got a metal part here. It's got nice rivet detail on it. One little itty bitty part, looks like some braces. We got our gauge package here. You can paint and put in separately behind the dashboard, but that's not it. That's not everything in the kit. Not even close. I also want to show you in the manual when you build that engine, They'll let you wire it. They'll even have you wire the breathers. They'll have you wire the oil lines, the coolant lines. They'll have you wire the coolers, the oil filters, everything. You can build it all in this kit. They've even got the breathers with the equalizer tube. All that is all in this kit, allowing you to mega detail all the parts that you need to. So what else we got over here? Well, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, of course, 16 scale Goodyears with the huge white letters on them, pad printed for you. All the rest of the detail for racing use only. Check that out, Blue Street. I mean, these are beautiful, beautiful tread. Sand those down if you like the black wall look, or if you want to detail your own, go right there. Otherwise, in this edition, that's all been done for you and lined up beautifully. Still not done, not even close. We got 3 sizes of tubing. We got this nice wet noodle tubing. We've got the yellow lines, I assume would probably be spark plug wires, so they stand out. And we've got a little bit of thicker wire for coolant and oil coolers and stuff like that. You get 3 lengths of tubing, still not done. We got glass parts, we got chrome parts. Look at the chrome tree on here with those wheels, and he ran the chrome wheels on this car. Brake drums on the inside, Hemi valve covers, all the little accoutrement tanks. Check out the shifter, even has the brand name carved into it. Wire separators, just unbelievable amount of detail on there. We've got our grill molded open, of course, in this scale. Spoiler, smaller trim parts, all with their little weld marks on them, or our rivet marks on them. They're so beautiful. Still not done. Got the large glass, windshield, back glass. We've got a clear valve cover so you can see inside if you want to paint up that valve train and all that. You can see down inside there in your model. And clear gauge package. So if you wanted to light the back of the dashboard, you could do so. Make it look like a real car. And the last thing in the box, the giant decal sheet. We got the 426 cubic inch, we got the STP logos, we got the 43, we got all the contingency stickers, Racer's Edge emblems, everything you need to make your own for the white pinstriper on the paint job. You'll have to supply that yourself. You can just paint that on there. And you are all set to go. That is all the awesome stuff. Of course, I will link down below, as always, where you can get yours. This is a sweet kit. This is going to be put on the back burner. This is going to get built at some point. I'm also hoping maybe we'll get lucky. They'll re-release the K&K insurance car, which is a lot easier to paint, but it's the exact same car underneath. We can have fun with that one as well. At the end of the video will be the still images of the sprues, and I will see all of you at the next review.